Hello, this is rickysun. I am a Pi engineer. Today, the topic of discussion is AF building. Why is it important? Because, you know, in a survey I conducted last year, 60% of you think AF is underutilized, right? As a framework is underutilized. And I want to see if this video can help you because I notice many company, usually smaller company, they are not using AF, right? They treat as a framework, they treat the Pi system as a data historian. They are not using AF at all. Some people may not even use AF. Some might be just have an example there, or sometimes like just that is partially built, right? And I want to see maybe there's a mental block, right? Blocking you, because I think at the beginning, right, I think AF is hard. And to tell you a little story, right, at the beginning of my osisoft career, like I can take all this public training, right, which you can pay for and then take, right, and AF and analytics, right, or those AF workshops, right. And I also can, in additionally, right, as an osisoft employees, you can take those internal training, but their name is like AF slam dunk, AF deep dive, right? And like I took those, like all this AF training, right? And one day, and then I like after I took the training, after a week, I forgot what it is because I didn't use it. And then I asked my coworker, how come this AF thing is so difficult to understand? And I don't understand like all these ingredients and why we need to learn this, right? Because he was like conducting a lot of AF workshops, so I asked him, right? And then I also job shadow. I try follow people, right, go to the workshop, AF workshop, right, see how the dynamic goes. Also, I build VMs, right, try to do the exercise, right, all this exercise. Yeah, no problem with doing this exercise, right. And one day, I guess one day, my manager asked me, hey, I will let you conduct AF workshop yourself. And then I go to my customer, and which is a plant, right? And that time I was by myself, and then before that I tried to prepare all these examples, right? I tried to redo all these training, right? And make sure I know all these examples and all that. And I go on site, deliver the training. And at the end, one of my customer come to me saying, are you new to osisoft? I was shocked because like I guess disappointed in myself because I already spent so much time, right, in osisoft, but my focus was not AF. I didn't really do a lot of AF work, but I did all this training. And I realized no matter how much training you did, if you didn't implement, like if you don't do hands-on, right, constantly help your customer utilizing AF, you will not know what it is. And I think the learning moment, I did not learn a damn thing like previously. I know the high level concept and that's it. And the learning actually start after I conduct my AF workshop. And because I finally know the power of it, and then I can excel from there. And to tell you a little bit of an analogy, right? It is like you are watching Michael Jordan on YouTube to play basketball, and you watch it many times. And finally, one day you go to the court and play basketball with other people and you suck. This is kind of like an analogy. I realize you don't know how to play basketball. This is kind of like the thing. Like, it's, you did not learn if you didn't apply what you learned. And to go back to the AF building, right? Building AF, after you know it, building AF is not hard at all. And for a small company especially, right? If you don't have the skill, just take the virtual online training about AF, know the basics, and then you can start. And my thought is, it takes 5 steps. Like, if you want to just start, you don't have to actually take the training, read the manual, know everything about the structure hierarchy, talk to people in your company about requirements of the structure or the tag naming convention or the substitution parameters. You don't need to know all this, or template actually. Like, template is a big thing, but you don't need to do any of that. And there's only 5 steps you needed to know, right? And then you can get started. The step number one is you go and talk to the plant people, the operator, the people who know what the plant is going on, right? There may be people who know the whole pictures. You talk to those people and ask them, is there any issue you want to solve but you haven't? And then they may tell you a problem, right? Let's say it is a tank leak, right? Constantly tank leak happens in different tank, and we want to prevent it because, you know, clean up is a mess. It's a hassle for them, it's a dirty work, right? And then also, like, it costs money, right, for hiring contractor to come to clean it up. It's an unnecessary thing, right, but you have to do it. And then step number two, once you talk to him, then he will tell you, hey, I got a tank, right? I got a tank example, and last week it was leaking, right? Then you will tell him which tank. You'll ask him which tank, right? And then, okay, tank in the Calgary. Tank number one in Calgary, let's say. Then you put that tank Calgary in your asset framework, right? That's an element. Step number three is, okay, what measurements can you use to detect tank leak? A level transmitter, he will say, right? And then you put that level transmitter into the attribute field for that element that we just created in the AF hierarchy. Now we got an AF structure. It's a small one, you know, nothing wrong with it though, right? It's not a big hierarchy, right? And then step number four is you create analytics based on this element and attribute. And you ask him, you know, how do we know this is a tank leak from this transmitter, level transmitter? He will be saying, you know, there are many times, like, if there is no leak, the level will be the staying the same. And if you have leak, it will go a little bit lower, like full time, right? For no reason, right? Like, this could be reason people open the tap and then there will be water coming out intentionally. And also, there might be some cases people, I mean, there is a hole at the bottom and then all the water come out, but people know. You cannot prevent those happen because that hole is big and, you know, there's nothing you can do about. But I'm talking about slow leak, right? He's talking about slow leak. So if we can detect, we can write an algorithm in the asset analytics to detect tank leak when there is a little, the level transmitter come down slowly for a time. We can do that, and then we work on the logics, right? As a Py engineer, you know how to t- talk to the beautiful thing about you being a Py engineer is you can talk to operators, multiple people to gather their requirement, their problems, and then put it into the Py system, right? And then you get the analytics done, right? That's step number four, right? And then you put in the logics, right? You know how because you're a Py engineer. And then step number five is, you know, create. When you create the analytics, you can attach the email to the event frame that you created, right? Like when leaks happen, you get a notification email, right? So he will get an email, right, when leaks happen, right? Now he's getting value because he don't want 10 leaks to happen. And then if he can detect it, then he will be happy. And even better, maybe I will add step number six is create a PyVision display for him, right? So he can show that tank name with the level transmitter on a trend, right? The level on the trend for that tank. And then you can attach that link of PyVision into the email. And that's it. You don't have to go fancy template, right? You don't have to think too crazy about, I have to have a big structure hierarchy before I start. All you need to do is just go in and do it. I don't know. It's like, I don't know why children, I have a 1 year old, she began to walk for no reason. She didn't read the manual. She didn't watch videos, but she just walked. I think this is what we should do to utilize AF system. And you know, of course you can, as your company grow, this AF hierarchy is not looking great, right? But so what? It deliver value, right? It deliver value for you already. And you know, you can hire, at that time you can hire an expert, you know, like those other piconsultant to help you make it look nicer and more scalable, right? And that's it. I just tell you like six steps and then you will be able to utilize AF. There's no more excuses. And thank you for watching, and please hit the subscribe button as well as the bell icon. I'll see you next week.